Buenas. Buenos días.
¿Estamos listos?
¿Estamos listos para empezar? Otra vez efecto de mono, por favor.
Bueno, pues buenos días a todos y bienvenidos al Microsoft 365 Saturday in Madrid, que este año, pues por ser una edición virtual, lo estamos celebrando un miércoles. Bueno, lo primero de todo, agradecer a las comunidades técnicas de Office 365 que existen por España, la comunidad Office 365, MathPoint, la comunidad técnica de Madrid, Subcat, la comunidad técnica de Cataluña y, por supuesto, a la revista Compartimos porque, bueno, sin su ayuda, su apoyo y todo lo que se hace desde las comunidades a lo largo del año, pues esto no sería posible.
El equipo de organización en el que estamos casi todos de aquí. Nos falta un clásico dentro de la keynote, que es Rafa. Desde aquí te saludamos, Rafa. Sé que estás a tope de trabajo y estás muy presente con nosotros. Y bueno, Ángel, Rubén, Luis, Ferran, bueno, los sospechosos habituales que solemos estar en cada sitio.
Bueno, que sepáis que en las redes sociales vamos a tener hoy mucho movimiento y este es el hashtag que tenemos que utilizar. Tenéis que estar muy atentos, retuitear mucho, mucho, mucho todo lo que vayamos publicando, porque puede que los que más retuiteen tengan alguna sorpresa, algún regalo. Y también a lo largo de la tarde pues tendremos una serie de rifas que luego contará Ángel. Y siempre, siempre tenemos que utilizar este hashtag dentro de Twitter, ¿vale? Así que os animo a todos, aquí dinamicemos entre todos y le demos un poco de presencia al evento.
Ángel, bueno, la presento yo, una parte. No, solo comentaros que tenéis aquí tenéis la agenda del evento, tenemos tres tracks. Sesiones durante todo el día, podéis ver o seguir todas las sesiones en YouTube, tenéis aquí el enlace, igualmente en las redes sociales también encontraréis ahí los enlaces. Ángel, ¿de qué van los tres tracks que tenemos por ahí?
Bueno, los tres tracks tenemos en partes de todo lo que es desarrollo en Teams, todo lo que es adopción, también tenemos Power Platform para los que les interesen, y muchas charlas interesantes de desarrollo. Y también hay una de Power BI e inteligencia artificial. Y bueno, al final del evento, pues como ha comentado Imanol, tenemos el cierre y que habrá muchas sorpresas en las rifas.
Vale, y como siempre queremos agradecer a nuestros patrocinadores, que sin ellos todos esos eventos no serían posibles. En este nos acompañan Aura, Abanade, Encamina, Everis, Intelequia, Cabel, Nexia, Raona, Rico y Tokiota. La verdad es que nos apoyan en todos los eventos y son un clásico.
Y por último, creo que lo que más esperamos todos, también tenemos rifa, aunque seamos virtuales, aunque este año no podamos llenar el auditorio para hacer esta rifa. No nos olvidamos de todos vosotros y, bueno, como ha comentado Imanol, estad muy atentos a las redes sociales durante el día de hoy. Escribid mucho con ese hashtag M365MathVirtual para que podáis tener las posibilidades de obtener alguno de los premios que tenemos aquí. Y para finalizar, bueno, vamos a dar bienvenida a Jeff Tipper también, con su tradicional vídeo que nos acompaña siempre en estas Keynote, que os dejamos y os compartimos con todos vosotros. Muchas gracias y que disfrutéis del evento.
Hi there, Jeff Tipper from Microsoft, and I am thrilled to be with you at Microsoft 365 Saturdays Madrid. For those of you who don't know me, I lead the engineering team for our core collaboration tools in Microsoft 365. I've worked on SharePoint for quite a while, as some of you know, and in February I took on responsibility for Microsoft Teams as well. A key part of what we do in Microsoft 365 is, of course, collaboration. And a big way we collaborate is with our communities around the world to help you understand the best practices of other organizations, our roadmap, and get feedback from all of you on how we can make our products better. And we are thrilled. It's challenging. We wish we were here in person with you, but we are thrilled to be part of this, a virtual event, and we are absolutely confident that this is the best community in tech as we've seen how you've responded to support each other through COVID. I think everybody knows the world's changed forever. As the global pandemic spread through Spain and the rest of the world, people have risen to the occasion to support each other and continue the missions of their organizations. It's been humbling at Microsoft to be able to support all of you in this, to help businesses, hospitals, schools continue their vital work in the face of this challenge. And we've learned so much of it that will be with us forever, and how we can help people collaborate any place, anytime, with anyone in a hybrid workplace and education environment. And so thank you so much for your bet on us. We don't take it for granted. And in fact, when the pandemic hit and we had to rapidly scale our services, we were in this position because of all of you. Many of you remember and were with us from our on-premises server days, Exchange, SharePoint, Link, and Skype for Business. We released them as a cloud offering. We didn't use that word at that point. In 2008, Bill Gates announced it at the SharePoint conference as Microsoft Online Services. We worked on it based on your feedback, and we took it to the next level with Office 365 in 2011. We continued to invest and innovate based on your input. And I was really excited 4 years ago to do a big event called The Future of SharePoint, where we talked about a new user experience and new platform and foreshadowed group collaboration with what would be the next year announced as Microsoft Teams. At that point, Office 365 had grown to 85 million monthly active users. And Teams was a catalyst to a complete collaboration solution that grew and grew. And in April of this year, we announced Office 365 had over 250 million active users, 75 million of them using Teams daily. And in the 4 years since the Future of SharePoint event, SharePoint had grown tenfold. So thank you so much for your feedback. It let us improve the product and invest, and we don't take any of that for granted. Satya talks about Microsoft 365 as the world's productivity cloud to empower every organization. People ask me, how do Teams and SharePoint fit together in that? And so the way I think about it is Teams provides this hub and communication services, and SharePoint provides flexible content management services that come together for a holistic collaboration experience and platform. And you'll see in the announcements we made at Ignite how we're reinforcing that innovation in Teams and SharePoint and the rest of Microsoft 365 together. In fact, Ignite, also done virtually, was our biggest news day yet, where we had incredible amounts of sessions and blogs, and it's easy to get lost in that. A lot of that's available online for you to watch. A set of it's going to be summarized at this event. But I thought I'd highlight just a few things for each of Teams and SharePoint, because you'll see the innovation, and you'll see how they fit together. So first, Teams. Teams is our hub for teamwork. We bring together communications tools, calls, chats, meetings in a single place, but also integrate collaboration tools like SharePoint, like Power BI, like Planner, and so much more, not just from us, but from third parties, so that we have a holistic way for a team to get work done together. It was a big set of announcements we made at Ignite. We're clearly doing a lot of work with meetings. Together mode is how we can be in the same virtual space together as opposed to little rectangles. We're doing custom layouts where we overlay presenters and content. I'm doing this now using a piece of hardware in a hardware box. You see sort of behind me is how we're going to do it in software, where everybody can look polished and deliver an engaging meeting. Breakout rooms, meeting recap to summarize the activities that happened in a meeting, the recording, the agenda, the follow-up items to make meetings more effective. Doing more and more to help teams be a foundation for webinars, for you to reach out to your customers and partners in polished sessions. We're doing a lot of work in Teams devices for meeting rooms, small and large. As we go back to hybrid work, these meeting rooms and their connections to Teams will be more important than ever. We have a new calling experience that's great. We have new ways to templatize Teams for different workflows, HR, marketing, finance. A new search experience that dramatically improves the relevance and access to information in Teams. Lots of work for developers, including the ability to build power apps right inside the Teams experience and the ability to extend the meeting canvas with your own extensibility mechanisms. So just tons and tons of new value for Teams to make it a better hub for teamwork for end users, for developers, and for IT. But we're not slowing down on SharePoint either. This is the biggest year we've ever had in SharePoint in new users and hiring new engineers in the team. So Teams is growing and SharePoint's powering it and other experiences. The way I think about it is SharePoint is our flexible content management system that powers these experiences inside Teams, but across the rest of Microsoft 365 as well. Great SharePoint sites, files experiences, including OneDrive, the new list experience that's available in SharePoint, but also outside the SharePoint shell. Video, I'll talk about that, knowledge with SharePoint syntax, and much more. So hopefully you saw a big set of announcements on SharePoint as well. I'll highlight just a few. So a lot of work to improve the OneDrive experience to give you anywhere access to all your files in a seamless single place. People say, hey, I just want to browse all my files, whether they're mine or on SharePoint or Teams or whatever, just simple, simple, simple. With Add to OneDrive, we have the ability across all your devices to have access to all your files. Microsoft Lists, we did a dramatic set of investments in the last year in the list experience in SharePoint. I'm so proud of it. But we also made that building block available in Teams in a standalone Lists applications, and we talked about a set of announcements there. We're doing more and more to make your intranet out of the box in both the browser and inside Microsoft Teams with a new home site app. That's backed up by a bunch of publishing features and integration with Stream and Yammer and so much more. We talked last year about Project Cortex, AI to content management. The first part of that is now available as SharePoint syntax, using AI to help organize content for business processes. We announced something very big that people have asked us for: the collaboration and security features of SharePoint for video in Stream and Teams recordings. In fact, we get often poked, why don't you have this feature or that feature that SharePoint has? Guess what? SharePoint natively now supports high performance video, or will soon, with work we're doing in Teams meeting recordings and Stream are being built on top of SharePoint. So you get all that collaboration, security, and extensibility capabilities SharePoint gives you. Tons of security work, sensitivity labels, information barriers, and so much more. So that's just scratching the surface of what we announced. I just really wanted to say thank you for all the support you've given us all over the years. It let us invest to help support people in a challenging time. Thank you for the feedback. It's let us do the kinds of innovation we did at Ignite. And thank you for hosting and being part of this amazing virtual event at Microsoft 365 Saturday in Madrid. Thanks.
Hi, everybody. I'd like to welcome you to the Microsoft 365 Virtual Summit. My name is Lori Pottmeyer, and I am the community lead for the Microsoft Teams engineering team. And it's my pleasure to welcome you on behalf of Teams engineering to this wonderful event. Teams is the hub for teamwork. It really is the epicenter of what we're all doing these days. With the move to all of us being online and virtual from day to day, it has been a big part of all of our lives, I'm sure you will agree. From meetings and calling to chat and collaboration and even apps and workflows, Microsoft Teams has really become a fixture in what we're doing day to day. We may have used Teams prior to COVID-19, but let's be honest, things have changed. Our lives are different. Not only are we working from home, but many of our children are at home, our family members are around, we're isolated, and things are very, very different. We have over 115 million daily active users for Microsoft Teams. That means that so many of us are glued to our computers, to our screens, for not just a couple of meetings a day, but every day, multiple meetings. And with that comes a lot of work for our team in making sure that we're delivering a quality product for you. We're somewhat of hamsters on a wheel, trying to keep going and making sure that we're scaling so that all of you have access to Microsoft Teams and that it's running fast and that it's working for you. We're trying to develop features that are now more important than ever for you. Things that you may not have really cared about a few months ago, but now are key to your job. That's why you'll see new things like the different video views to have a more engaging meeting experience and other things that we've recently outlined at Ignite. We're also driving innovation. We don't want to just keep up with our competitors. We want to be innovative and do some of the things that we plan to do and some of the big meeting-related, device-related, IT pro-related functionality and features to make Teams a really world-class product, as well as we want to gain your trust. It's very, very important that you know that Microsoft Teams is building a product with you in mind. We want to integrate your thoughts and your needs into the product. And that's why it's very important that you share your feedback with us on a regular basis and that we're open with you as to what our priorities are as well. I hope that you'll use the user voice site to share your feedback with us and to keep up using the user voice as well as our roadmap that you can find at aka.ms Teams roadmap to get the latest on what we're working on. We've been really busy here at Microsoft Teams, keeping up with what you all are asking for and what we know is important given the current status that we're all working in. And so I wanted to share a few of my favorite features that have recently been released. And the first one is being able to show offline. And this helps me when I'm working off hours so that people can get answers from me and I can continue to work off hours, but I'm not necessarily showing online. So I don't need to feel like I have to respond right away to people on off hours. And this really helps with my work-life balance. The other thing is being able to transfer meetings between devices. So if I'm on my cell phone to start a meeting because I'm trying to get my kids ready in the morning, but I want to listen in on our team meeting, I can do that and 10 minutes later come back to my computer and seamlessly join the meeting on my computer without having to hang up and redial in or reconnect. The other thing is speaker names added to live captions. And for some people who are using live captions on a regular basis, it's very important that they know who's actually speaking. I also like the ability to force the mute function with the attendees. So as a presenter control, I'm able to now to mute the attendees and make sure that there's a quality experience with the meeting. And then finally, Spotlight video. Again, this is extremely important in education with schools. so that teachers can lock the video on a single person, as well as in a presentation when there may be multiple presenters joining or people talking from time to time, but we want to lock the presenter video on a single person. Again, all of the features can be found at Teams Roadmap or Teams What's New to see what has been released recently. You can find that at the website listed on the slide, and you can also find that within the client itself on the lower left-hand corner of your screen. I also wanted to strive to, or I want to share with you the importance of striving to stay connected beyond the work, because we have work and we're able to connect on Teams on a regular basis, but really it's important that we maintain that human connection. And some of the things that my team here, this is the quality and customer obsession team, or at least part of the quality and customer obsession team at Microsoft Teams, they say hello. We are really working on making sure that we're staying connected as a team. And some of the ways we do that is by happy hours once a week. We have morning meetings where we connect as a team for 30 minutes. That's optional, but it gives us a time to kind of connect like we might in the office had we been all together. We also do things like leadership lunches, and we have buddies. So we use the apps in Microsoft Teams to connect us and do meetups on a regular basis with individuals. So each week I have a buddy that I get together with, and we just connect and make sure that we're all doing okay. And it gives us an opportunity to connect one-on-one like we might do at the water cooler or in the lunchroom. So I urge you to think of ways that work for your organization as well. I also wanted to share a couple of community resources. One is the Microsoft Teams community, or the MTC. And the tech community is a great place to ask questions, but also to give back. So if you're somebody that likes to see what other people are asking, go in there and check it out. If you have things to share, it would be great if you go in there and proactively answer questions from other people, or take the opportunity to share your experiences, whether that's something that you've learned because it's gone wrong, or something that worked well that you think would benefit the rest of the community. Additionally, feedback. It's very important that we get your feedback, and by entering it in User Voice, we have a programmatic way to collect your feedback and look at priorities. This helps us tremendously stack rank the different things that are coming in and being asked, and it also helps us reprioritize when your priorities shift. And we saw that with COVID, and we're able to do that. So please continue to put your feedback there. We do use it, and we do look at it on a regular basis. There's lots of ways to get involved. I know there's a lot on this slide, but definitely check out the tech community. If you're interested in writing a blog, we have a community blog space. I would not only urge you to go in there and read the blogs, but if you're somebody that's passionate about Microsoft Teams and wants to share, I'd love to highlight you there as well. And finally, resources. There's lots of resources out there, the roadmap, the community, the blog spaces, and the feedback. And then finally, the virtual hub, which is the last link there. We've got some great new content, and we continue to add content on a regular basis on the topic of Microsoft Teams. So with that, I thank you for being here. I appreciate your passion for Teams. I'm so happy to have you part of the community. And I thank you for not only attending and learning, and hope that you will share your knowledge moving forward. Thank you again on behalf of Microsoft Teams Engineering. Have a great rest of your day.